guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you my personal blow dry routine. Before we get started, if you're already subscribed, you know that I'm not a professional hairstylist whatsoever. I've never gone to school or anything like that. But for the last couple months, I've been trying to tackle how to blow dry my hair because I love the way it looks on other people. But for me, that was the hardest thing in doing my hair. I could never figure out how to make it look decent from just blow drying it. So I do end up going in with my flat iron at the end just to get like my baby hairs right here that tend to like get a little curly no matter what I do. So I feel like what I do is so easy, and I feel like it's perfect for beginners, or if you're just starting out or you have no idea how to do it or how to even start, I think that this is for you. If you're already really good at it, you're gonna hate this video because it is so basic. So I hope that you guys enjoy this video. Please subscribe if you're not already, and let's just jump right into it. So this obviously starts when your hair is wet, and this is my favorite product to use right out of the shower. This is the It's a 10 Miracle Leave-In product, and this is the one that does not have keratin in it. And so I just spray this all throughout my hair, including my ends, and I just avoid the roots, but I bring it up pretty high because I have some breakage up that's really high and I need this to get up in there. So then I go in with just a wide tooth comb and just brush it through so that it will evenly distribute this product throughout the hair, and it also makes brushing it throughout easier because it's like conditioning the hair. This product also has a heat protectant in it, and it does a bunch of other stuff. So then I'm just sectioning off the top part of my head because this is where I'm going to be using rollers because it's really the only place that I want rollers. So I section this off into one big piece, and then I'm going to make three separate sections, starting with the back piece and then clipping the front section away as its own piece that I will be dividing later. So I'm gonna use this dry bar brush. I believe this is the medium sized brush. And I'm gonna start by brushing out this piece, and then I lay the brush down, grab my blow dryer. This is just the Qi Air. It's really not that good. It's kind of old, so any blow dryer will work. And as you can see, I'll blow dry it and then I'll set it down, reposition my brush, and go back in. Honestly, that is what has made it so much easier for me to do my hair, because when you see the ladies at the salon doing it, they are just going to town, going so fast. And for me, I cannot catch on, and I don't have the technique skills to do that. So I will blow dry it, set it down, reposition it, lay the brush back down, and then pick the blow dryer back up and do the drying part or whatever. So I really do think that the brush also helps to dry the hair quicker as well. So once I've dried that pretty well, I'm gonna go in with one of these rollers from Drybar. It is the smaller size, and I just roll that down on that piece of hair and secure it in the back by just wiggling it. And as you can see, it just stays. It's so easy, you don't need any clips to keep it in place. It's just the roll because it's kind of like Velcro-y. Now I'm going to split that front section again in half and do the exact same thing. Like I was saying about the brush, I feel like that yellow plate in the back, you know, you see the yellow part on the brush, I feel like that heats up really hot, so it's really going to help to dry your hair faster and smoother and not be frizzy. I'm using another one of the small rollers there to do the middle section, and then this front section, I'm actually going to use one of the bigger rollers that comes in the box. You can see here that it's a lot bigger than the smaller one that I was using. The reason why I like the bigger one is because it gives me a ton of volume right in the front. If I use the bigger ones on the other two sections, then it's just way too much volume that I can't handle. So that's totally up to you. I'm gonna section off the rest of my hair right above my ear. And on the bottom section, I don't really pay too much attention to it. I just kind of go in with my brush and my blow dryer just to make it straight and smooth it out. I'm not too particular with this. That's totally up to you if you want to be. I show you how I do it more particularly in the next section. So I'm just kind of smoothing this over right here. And then I'm going to take down the top section that I clipped away, and I'm going to be a little bit more precise. So I'm going to take a little section here and do the same thing like I did with those top pieces. I will use the blow dryer to blow dry it straight. Once I get the blow dryer to the end, I'll grab it, reposition my brush, and do it again. And for me, the more slow I go, it's just easier to manage, because if I just like go to town, it's like,
it's crazy, sloppy, and frizzy. So as you can see, I kind of didn't really do the sections like I did on that back one, but usually I do if I want it to be more precise. And the reason why I'm a little bit more sloppy with the bottom pieces and I get more precise the higher up I go on my head is because that's the part that you're really going to see, at least on me. And I feel like the bottom just gives it more fullness without being more precise like that. So yeah. Once I've completed the rest of the hair, I'm gonna start taking out the rollers and I start at the back. I use the roller to brush out the piece and then I go in with my brush to brush it out again. And as you can see, it just gives you instant hella volume. It is absolutely insane. So I'm just gonna continue brushing out the rest of them and messing around with it and seeing kind of like what I need to do to tweak the hair. Because, I mean, if you're feeling it, you can leave it like this, but holy crap, that is a ton of volume. Now I'm just taking my Numi flat iron. This is my favorite flat iron that I've ever used. I do have some coupon codes down below. But see this, like, wiggly piece right here, like those little baby hairs? I just take that to go over them. Honestly, this is unnecessary. You could use your blow dryer to do this, but it's just handy for me. It's right there. It's quick. This thing heats up in 2 seconds, so I'm just gonna go over those just to smooth it out. So then I like to go in with this agave oil. This is amazing. I use a teeny, 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 tiny bit, really rub it into my hands, and then I work it through my hair, mainly on the ends. But once you've distributed a lot of it to the ends and you have a little bit left over on your hands, you can bring it up higher, especially for me because I've got so many broken ends, but also if you have baby hairs that are sticking up kind of like I do, you can kind of smooth them out, but you wanna make sure that you don't have a lot of oil left over because you also don't wanna make your hair look greasy or anything. So I feel like this really smooths the hair, makes it look really shiny, and it's really, really healthy. I got this product like 2 or 3 years ago, and I'm still not even halfway through this oil. Oils are awesome. So this is the end result. Obviously, you could make it a lot more detailed when you're doing your styling, but I'm a beginner. If I can do it, you can do it, and I really think that this would help you out if you're just getting started. So that's the finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope that this kind of simplified the process for you, made it a little bit more easy, and just easier overall to achieve. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Give this video a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you're not already, and don't forget to let me know all of your video requests down below in the comment section, and I will see you guys in the next video. No, I'm not trying to be rude, but hey, pretty girl, I'm feeling you. The way you do the things you do remind me of my Lexus cool. That's why I'm all up in your grill, trying to get you to a hotel. You must be a football coach, the way you got me playing the field. Now it's like